gas.
I'll catch you in the lead, pack leader.
Oh, look at that. Holy boy. This full feature-length episode here on Ultimate Fishing is one of my favourites. Not just because we had incredible fishing, but because there was a bit of competition and because of the lads I had along. Fresh from winning the Rugby World Cup, I had two groups of All Blacks, a team from the North Island, a team from the South Island. And when you get fierce competitors like that together, yes, there was some friendly rivalry, but it also got pretty serious and we had a heck of a good time. It was a special one for me because I was out here on my own back paddock here in the Bay of Islands, hosting a great bunch of guys. And for me as a rugby fan, it was huge. The fishing was amazing, the weather was amazing. So tune in and check it out. One of the most memorable trips I've had in quite some time.
Hello, pal.
Howdy.
Yeah.
Righto, you boys know the rules. We talked through that earlier. Toss a coin. You call it, Rico.
Heads.
Heads it is.
We'll go with Matty today, I think.
Nice.
You'll need all the help you can get.
Yeah.
Good luck, boys.
Cheers. As usual, go pal. Well. Righto.
Well, there you go, fellas. Well, we might as well rip into it. Jump on the boat, guys. And here we are again. The latest incarnation of the ITM North versus South Fishing Challenge. Looks like I've got South with me today. This motley crew over here, the North, they're going to be jumping on with a local charter boat. As far as fishing competitions go, these guys are pretty competitive, so should be a bit of fun.
Good luck, fellas.
One-way traffic.
There's no doubt that this year's comp is going to be fiercely contested by the teams from the North Island and the South Island, where each team has to catch a whole range of different species from here in the Bay of Islands. And for the first half, I've got the most elite fishers selected to represent the South Island. And while it's a competition, there's no denying these guys are out to have some fun.
See, we've got a bit of a mix of bait, fish and snapper down here, but up here, these individual targets, these curves, they're snapper up off the bottom feeding. And they're the ones that we want to be dropping lures into because they're going to be aggressive. So I'm picking the boys should hook up pretty well here. Stand by.
We got something worth putting her into, have we?
Yep. Away you go, guys. Drop, 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 drop. Oh, there you go. That's a better fish. That's a better fish, mate. that's a good fish, mate. Just nice and smooth, mate.
Oh, nice colour.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good size fish.
Oh, yeah. It's a nice snapper, mate. Bring them on over. Just slide them on over. That's a good eating size too. And we're on the board, boys.
That's a good snapper.
Yeah, mate, that's a good one to start, eh? There you go. Easy as that, he says. And and it really was that easy.
Right, we're going to set this up.
Okay. We're still getting set up. We're not really organised, to be honest. But these boys are so keen. I just said, we'll just stop here. There's a few marks. We'll have a bit of a practice. Well, practice has turned into the real thing pretty quick. So you have to excuse me not doing my TV job there, talking you through it. You guys will have my job by the end of this. You're looking for a job, aren't you, Rico?
Yeah, I am actually, yeah. Funnily enough.
Take the photo. The V of the tail has to be showing in the photo. Let's get out of the road. Haven't heard from those North Island lads yet, so I think you fellas have got first points on the board. Not bad. Not bad, fellas.
The North Island team are also starting off by targeting snapper. The rules allow just 8 snapper to score points.
You need to work on your casting, Guzzle.
So before moving on to the long list of species, each team is trying to register 8 good-sized snapper.
Nice, Dougie.
And after a slow start, it's Nuggie that is first to register points for Team North with a decent snapper.
Good nugget.
Real good from you, Nug.
We're on the board.
Get the photo.
How good!
But while fishing for snapper, the teams can score on several other species, including the kingfish that often feed on the same bait for shoals as the snapper that we're targeting.
Your jig's a bit high at the moment, Sam. There you go, I'm keeping an eye on. You can see that Sam working his bottom ship here. Fish it down a little bit deeper, and it's just a nice luxury. Bound to have the iPad out here in the cockpit, you can see exactly what's going on. Cool, eh? Sam's on up front there too. Just walk it down this way for us, Sam. Then Ricco can net it for you. Oh, mate, Sam! Hey! Hey! Oh, you beauty!
It's all go.
Any much bigger than this, and we're definitely letting them go, I think, fellas. Yeah. Breeding, but... Nah, I think we'll... Nah, that falls inside the eating size. Sammy, well done. Yep.
Yeah, lift up a little bit higher.
Oh yeah, boy!
Okay. Nice, Cobra.
Oh yeah, it's got a bit of load to it, that fish. Oh yeah, boy. It's got to be a kingy. Leader, kingy. Okay, just leave him in the water. Steer him around, and I'll see if I can pop him in the net for you. There you go, mate. If that goes 75 centimetres, we'll be able to measure it. And that'll be 75 points, lads. If you want to eat one, you want to eat one of these just legal ones rather than the biggies.
Yep.
Yeah, he's over, so he's points.
Hell of a fight.
Forearms screaming too.
Wowzers.
Look at the size of that. Hey, it is like sprat fishing, but it's a serious bit of kit. Seriously nice bit of kit. Here we go. Ooh! You know, if you can't make the snapper any bigger, you just, well, and, oh yes, this one might be a reasonable fish actually. You just drop down your gear. This is just a little, oh, hang on, can't talk about the tackle. Worrying about the fish, just for the moment. Okay, got this fish under control. So this here's just a little backbone elite, and it's a micro jig setup, so it's only a little 1,000 reel. And you'll see the jig when I bring it up. It's just one of the little Colt Sniper flat fall jigs. And because these fish are up off the bottom, here we go. This is a nice eating snapper. Let's see if I can lift this in without breaking it off. I've got a very light trace. There we go. Here's the jig I got him on. That's just a nice eater. So I think we might take that one back. And you can see there, this is the Colt Sniper flat fall. It's got these scallops out of it. The whole idea is it flutters on its way down, and it spends more time in the water column. I saw those fish high in the water column. I've got a range of jigs and stuff ready to go, and I flicked this one on. And that was good fun. For our Hunting and Fishing New Zealand tackle tip this week, we're going to look at the range of metal lures you can use when you're marking schools of snapper, particularly when they're on bait fish. Now, this guy here is the Shimano bottom ship. We know how well this works. Now, I would use this in a situation where it's quite deep and there's quite a bit of breeze and you really need to bomb down fast. And the action is to drop it down and to slow jig it. Get that little skirt swinging up. We've seen how effective they are. Now, this one here is the Shimano rock hopper. Similar to the bottom ship, but the lure slides up and down. So you can have slightly more angle on your line and you work it just a little bit slower. So just a nice slow jigging action, and you can really entice some strikes on these, particularly if they're not feeding aggressively. I find the rock hopper to be a lot better. Now, if the water's a little bit shallower or the fish are higher in the water column and you want your lure to be working a lot slower through the water column, that's when I go for this guy here. Now, this is the flat fall Colt Sniper. So there you go, if you've got a range of lures, when you find some fish, you should be able to hook up. Oh, what are you doing, Guns?
I'm catching the lead pack leader.
Oh, look at that. Holy boys.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, look at that. Holy boys. That could even be big kingies or something, holy. Look at them, they're going nuts. I've never seen anything like that out here before. And I just so happen to have this in my hand. I'm on. Take this rod. Let's get a little gas. Get more tight. Holy. Did you get that shot then?
Yeah.
Mate, how could you not? Mate, you get the sack if you miss that. Okay, just guide him round this way, Ricko. Guide him round. Yeah, lift him with the rod. Yeah, no, that's not a kahawai.
It's not a kahawai.
Oh, I don't know. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's an all right kingy too. There's nothing wrong with that, boy. Oh, boy. That was all right. That's an all right one. Jeez. Now I've got the pressures on. I've only got this little wee gaff. Gotta try and get it. Okay, don't just walk backwards, walk backwards. Jeez. He's only just hooked. Just hooked. Just get ready to, if I let go. Yeah, boy. Yeah, boy. Oh, look at that, the hooks came out. The hooks came out when we got our fish. Right.
Oh, well done.
Good effort, mate. Good effort, bro. That's it, mate. That's it. Right. Well, what we'll do is we'll measure him first and got the tail in there. You got him? 98, yeah. Bloody beautiful. Yeah, mate, that's it. You make these fish look small. Cobus, can I get you on? Can I jump in there and grab a pick? Because I've got plenty of picks of kingfish that size, but I've got none with Richie McCaw. Wicked, bro. Right, let him rip. See, well done. So there you go, fish goes back, and that's how this competition format works. You know, if it was a kill 'em all sort of a comp where you've got to weigh your fish in, a fish that we otherwise don't need to eat, we've got a nice little kingy, beautiful for eating, we can get a pick, which is the trophy. Well, it's a trophy for Rico. My trophy was I got to have a play with Richie McCaw. Sorry, I'm a bit of a fanboy.
Why kingy?
No, no, because, yeah, well, that's all right, mate. You get in the starting lineup, mate, and I'll get a photo with you. Now, with this sort of fishing, this is real handy. I just flick my pilot on here, and I've got a number of modes. Sabiki mode. I hit that, and now the boat's going to drive itself and hold us on top of these marks here. So, the motor's in reverse, and it'll just make tiny adjustments and it'll hold the boat's orientation exactly where I want it so we can carry on fishing. Pretty cool.
Got him now, though.
There you go, that's a better fish too, is it? Oh yeah, go! That's better.
The Furuno gear has once again found us the fish. So we're using a combination of lures and live baits to catch the fish while they're actively feeding.
Nice, that's a little bit better. Oh yes, on the live bait, you've got him, mate.
Yeah, okay.
We've found a patch of fish. You got your phone handy, Cobus?
Meanwhile, the lads in Team North have been on anchor. And it's not until they up anchor, get moving, and switch over to lures.
Got him, Nug.
Relax.
Hook him in, Nug.
That they start catching some fish.
Get him in the bag.
And scoring some points.
Points.
Right on, Nug.
Yeah, boy. About time.
Got a good snap here, Wood.
We're on the board here.
Yeah? Oh, yeah.
He's well and truly hooked.
Yes. How good.
Oh, yep.
But North still have a lot of ground to make up.
Happy about that, eh?
And with Rico and the South boys constantly hauling in snapper and extending their lead.
A good size snapper.
Oh, mate, good work. On the bottom ship. Now you're doing it, boys. Go on. Okay, you can go home, mate.
Yeah, sweet, another nice one. Got a good feed there, beautiful.
There you go. There you go, you're into one crop. Yeah, we must be close to our eight. Yeah, he's into one. Yeah. Meanwhile, while we're busy doing all of this, the Furuno Savikimo is just holding us over the fish. So these guys are keeping me busy catching fish and I don't have to drive the boat. Brilliant.
It's miserable.
Can't keep up with Sam on the bloody bottom ship. So make sure you hold the jig. If you hold the line, it can break. Oh, reckon we might just flick him straight back over, eh? If he's healthy. I think we've got our eight. We're not gonna really gain much by measuring that one, I don't think.
Here we are.
Oh yes, Rico. Get him moving, mate. That's a nice fish. Get him moving, that's it. You beauty. They're chewing right on bite time. Okay, if he's...
Okay.
You can go back to chuck him over, mate. He'll be fine.
Don't need to measure that, it's not worth it, is it?
Nah, we won't measure that one. Then we're going to want to measure the one that Rico's got on, though.
Here we are.
There we go, just leave him in the water.
He's well hooked.
There you go. And there you go, that's not a huge snapper by any stretch. Nice eater, and it smoked a big live bait.
Good size, bait for the fish.
I know, incredible, eh? Good going, mate. Right, this one's going to come in with us. Well, we're just tidying up some of this kingfish that'll be tataki for the lads tonight. And we got through the snapper. Reasonable start. Will it be enough for South to take it out this year?
It is another day tomorrow.
It is another day tomorrow. And it's a night tonight. Enough said. See you tomorrow.
This is the fiercely contested North v South ITM Fishing Challenge. Fished over two full-on days in the Bay of Islands.
Heads.
Heads it is.
And after winning the toss, Team South fished with me aboard my Staby craft. And the rules for the comp are simple. Each team measures and photographs their catch, they keep what they want to eat, and release the rest.
Got a good feed there, beautiful.
The points are scored at 1 point per centimetre, and the team with the most combined points wins. But there are limits. Each team can only score with a maximum of 8 snapper, 3 kingfish, 3 deep water species, and 3 inshore species. So on day 1, both teams had the same tactic. Catch the 8 snapper, and then move on to the other species.
Hey! Hey! Oh, you beauty!
It's now day 2, and the teams have switched boats, and the second half is about to kick off.
Good luck, boys!
So long, gay boys.
So far, Team South have caught all 8 of their snapper and 2 out of 3 kingfish, giving them a good lead over Team North.
Yeah, the South boys today are with Anglers Anonymous. They've got a fair start, let's say, but I've got the North guys, and if yesterday's performance and last night's performance was anything to go by, these guys are in some fine form. One problem, the guy driving. Guys, you know where you're going?
I don't know where I'm going. Just don't hit the rocks.
Don't hit the rocks. Don't hit the rocks.
One
okay,
drop,
I better
drop.
Go and get on the helm.
Here we go, strip it.
Bait stacking up here. Okay, go. Got a whole stack of bait fish. Could even be a couple of kingfish marks on there. We've got Muggy up the front. He's working the jig on the overhead jigger. And it's gonna get Guzz. You're gonna go on that live bait, eh?
Yeah.
Go now, get your thumb on it.
You're on, Nug.
He's on.
Yes. Nug's into one, Nug's into one. Don't let him wreck you. Just slowly let it down.
Don't let him wreck you.
We've got another one over here. We'll,
oh yeah.
Tighten up. Haven't had much of a chance, see, there you go, haven't had much of a chance to get set up, mate, right on those marks. Thank you for Uno bringing us right to them, and the pebble stick jigs went down, and boom, into it. Okay, just rats. That's all right, just walk them down the back here. We'll take care of it. So I'll show you how to deal with these only little guys. But, okay, so you grab it by the jig. I've got to be a little bit careful because I've got a crook shoulder, but you swing it under your arm, upside down, like so, under the wing, pop the hook out, and away. Alright, you get that, Kano?
Yeah.
You try to take Woody's one. Grab it by the jig. Yep, there you go.
Put them under the arm.
Under your wing, mate. Yeah, there you go, mate, and straight over the side.
See you later, mate. Back in?
Yeah.
Nuggy's on again.
Jesus!
Is that better,
Nuggy?
Yep.
Kano's on as well.
Give him the elephant, you need me holding on, you Nuggy. I'll strap you down.
Feels pretty big, mate. It's knocked the wind out of me already. Can't even do anything.
I've got some serious arm pump going on.
I'm knackered.
I tell you what, they're fighters, these, eh?
Got them on, brother. Give it a wind. Just give it a slow wind. It's all go in the land of the giants. Is that a big JD? Oh, double pointer! Double points! Yeah. Double points. Slow down, slow down, slow down.
This is a double pointer, this one, boy.
Yeah boys! Like double pointer! Yeah, boys! Hey. The JD! Yeah, that's a nice one, too. Yeah. Does, eh?
Triple pointer.
Look at that. The John Dorsey, look, see the live bait, you can't even see it.
Yes.
So what they do is they swim around, because they're not the fastest bloody fish going around like a kingy, which attack their prey, they use their slim profile, and they blend them with the weeds, and they'll sneak up behind, and just like the guzzler, boof, telescopic mouth.
I can't believe the similarities.
Look, everything, eh?
Keep bringing those in, though, that'll do.
Okay, this is a measure one, is it? Oh, yep, this one will be a measure, and then this will be your... Right, well, you want to get the mat, and you fellas get your photo, got your cards. How many kingies did you guys measure yesterday?
One.
You measured one, so we've measured two. So we measure one more kingie, we've got our three, and then we've got to decide whether we want to upsize them for more points, or whether we try for some other species. Those guys have gone out for pooka. They get three of those, mate, 380 centimetre fish. We'll make sure we get our third kingie, measurable kingie first.
You and Nug?
Oh, yeah, Nuggy's got a good one on.
Lift your rod tip up.
Yep. Lift your rod tip up. There you go, mate. I'll roll that GoPro there for you. You're under control. Actually, we're out of control. we're anything but under control. Oh, he's hooked up the other back.
Nug, you've just extended your lead massively. And ours.
Oh, we've got a tangle here, guys. Don't break off.
Under the rules of the tournament, each team is allowed a maximum of three kingfish. Team North have measured two so far and are trying to catch their third.
They're just like kingfish, only smaller. Right. Good, good. That's good, good stuff, guys. We just need to make them bigger.
There's loads of kingfish here, but most of them are small and not eligible for points. So they could be taking a risk by putting in a lot of time and effort to catch a kingfish. Time that may be better spent catching some of the other species in the tournament, like kahawai, trevally, gurnard, and John Dory. But not barracuda.
Cuda here, which is not the ideal thing for us, given that we're going to be heading out for pooka or some pooka bait.
Team South are already out wide, making the most of the perfect conditions, fishing for the tournament's deep water species, which includes hapuku, bass, and bluenose. If they catch three of these, they'll extend their lead from yesterday, and they'll be looking good to take out the ITM North vs South Fishing Challenge for another year.
He's on?
Yep,
he's
on.
Get up there, Kim. Okay. Nice, Cobus.
New spot, it's going good.
Oh, it's not a biggie, but it's a
bass.
Oh, it's a bass, is it?
Good work, Kobe.
Hey, Bessie.
Cobus.
It does.
All right, add to the tally. You on?
Pretty sure it's a small one, but I'll take anything nothing right now. It's been a dry couple of days.
Halfway here.
Yeah, I can see colour straight down.
Yeah, there's colour there now, I see it.
Nice work.
Outstanding.
We'll measure that one, eh?
230 odd metres down, it's a little bit tough to check your bait.
The decision to head out and target deep water fish is paying off for Team South. Not only are these hapuku and bass fantastic eating fish, they're good fish to get in the fishing competition, because the team with the greatest combined length of fish takes out the ITM Fishing Challenge. So even these modest-sized pooka are long, and they're worth valuable competition points.
Where's McCaw though, Crockett?
So despite being a team member down, Team South have now filled their tournament limit of three deep water fish and extended their lead. But they've opted to continue fishing here in the deep for bigger fish rather than going for the points on offer by catching three of the inshore species, a tactic that may prove costly. Meanwhile, Team North are still trying to catch their third kingfish. They need just one more. So I found another spot that's showing good sign and the guys are trying to get them on jigs. Keep it going, Nug. I can see them, they're after your jig.
I'm knackered.
Now what's going on here is we've got all this bait fish and we've got these arches, bigger marks on top, which are the kingfish. You can see the jigs dropping down and you can even see the kingfish coming up and following the jigs. And then they're pulling out at about that level there and going back down. Some more coming on now. There you go, look, more coming on now and he's just hooked up. There you go, that's okay, how it works. That's how the system works. I was watching your jig. I was watching them come after it on the TV, mate. Oh, yep. Oh, yeah, boy. Yeah, boy.
Yes. Look at
our little one. Oh, yeah,
Nug. Oh, just let it. You don't wind up too far. Yeah, boy. There you go, Nug. Come down here and make this fish look big.
Yeah, photo with it.
Yeah, mate. We'll get a photo with on it.
Oh,
I tell you what.
Sweating.
I'll let you have a photo with me now. See if you've got a good fish.
Do it. Alright.
It's good, eh? Just a little halfback driving these forwards around the place.
He's running.
Leading by example. You're running the show, bro. That's a nice fish. Get go. Oh, sweet bicks.
Deadly sweet bicks.
So, you know, we might get a metre 20, metre 30 one, like a real big one, but if it's 30 centimetres bigger than what we've got, that's only 30 points, whereas you catch one puka, and it's going to be 50 points. Catch one kahawai, it's going to be 40 points, if you know what I mean. It's not much. It's up to you whether you want to have more fun with kingies or whether you want to go for the win.
Here we go for the win. Here we go.
Go on, Nug. You've done your job, bro. We're going to maybe go and have a look for something else.
Team North still have some ground to make up on Team South. But rather than follow Team South and go deep for the big stuff, the plan is to first fill their tournament limit of kahawai and trevally.
See that little tiny little blue jig on that tiny little wee rod? Give that a cast, it might get eaten by them. Got him. Here, boys. Yep. There you go. When you snag one of these fish quite often, a kingy will come and try and eat it off your hook. So long as it's a measure fish, trevally or a kahawai. It is a, if it's a trevally, mate, we've got mean sashimi. It's a trevally. It's a trev.
Love a good sashimi.
Okay, just go easy on him. Just walk him to the back, he's not hooked real good. Oh, look at this, and what he's on skis. Good work, bro, that's mean sashimi. We'll get him on ice. Come and get this, come and get the big fella. The big fella on the miniature rod.
This thing's got no chance. Yeah, the reel's gonna snap off.
Yeah, you hook one. Yeah. Yep, these are all. Well, we'll get them whatever way we can, mate. They're all points. Don't know where to film, mate. You guys are too hard out.
Oh, there's so much going on.
Another trip here. You got me to net them? Get them any way you can, boy. Watch out for those dripper hooks. I'm nervous when Gus has got those dripper hooks. Get out of the road, Woody. No, you've not got enough. Link, give it a rip. He's gonna hook a bird or something. Tell me you're gonna get one there, Gus. Look, they're on top of the boat. Woody's on. Oh, what are you doing, Gus?
I'll catch him in the lead pack leader.
Yeah, go, Gus. That's perfect. There, got him. Bring him round, Gus. Bring him round the back.
There he comes. You're uncoordinated at the best of times.
Oh, ripped him off.
Oh, geez, that was disappointing there.
He's on the light here, mate. Make it count, boys. Oh, it's a big kahawai. Just don't lift him out of the water. Don't. Gus. Oh, Gus. That could be the winning of the comp. Yay. Get him in, mate. Get him in down here. Measure it. Oh, I'd never be so pleased to catch a kahawai. And there you go. That's the great thing with this sort of competition format. By having a range of different species, it takes all the heat and concentration about snapper, 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 and you can catch a whole variety of fish. You see, it's not just about staying on the same species and hauling them in one after the other. Typically, you'd catch a kahawai and go, meh. Today, that's 50 points. Yes. That's 30 points. Good work. Good work, boys.
All right.
What's that?
There we go.
You're ready to go again, eh? I'm impartial too. You know, I am North Islander, but I'm being impartial.
I didn't say it, okay.
Oh!
Yep.
He's got it.
Hit my balls.
Species are slowing
around on it for ages too.
Wally just did it.
Yep. Nice, Lukey. Nice, Kobe. About time you stood up.
It's starting to float now.
We all need to step up. McCaw's not here.
Shark.
Oh, well, that's some points.
That's 150 points.
That's some serious points.
We're quite weathered. Sharks are points. Points are points, no
way. Rules are rules. Rules are rules. Points are points.
Need one more
drop? No, I don't
need
one. Just say, hypothetically speaking, you know, if the fish was too big for the net, what should we do?
Put something alongside it that we can re-measure to verify it, so long as it's in the photo.
Okay, we might just measure up against Luke. I think Luke's probably about the same length.
Hear that? That was crocky. Those boys are onto hooker, and they reckon they got one that's bigger than the measuring man. They must be out here somewhere.
There you go. There they are out there. So. They're catching some pookas. I'll just turn the radar on and I've marked them. They're actually not far away from one of my pooka spots. So I've locked them onto my radar so we can track them wherever they go. Yeah, true. Like, so long as they stay within radar range, we'll know where they are all day so they can't bullshit us.
Wow.
That's fishing.
Yep, that's high-tech fishing. No, where is McCaw? Is he with you guys?
No, I thought you guys had a...
Where did you guys last see McCaw? Last night.
He's refusing to fish because he doesn't want to taint his reputation.
Can we borrow one of those electric reels?
Yeah, sure.
Come get it.
Yeah, a cracker.
Come on, mate.
What a cracker. Okay, so we've got a live bait on your top hook, Gus. For your bottom hook, we're just going to use the sleeve of that barracuda you caught. It's a nice tough bait. We go long and skinny baits. So they flap around nicely. Always put your hook through the skinny end of the bait. You can, with a nice tough bait, just go through once, but if you are going to go through twice, you go through over the barb and you come straight back through real close so it doesn't bunch the bait up, just like that. And that'll hang there like that. And you can see by the way that bait is, if something grabs it and you strike, you're not going to hook anything. You've got to let them eat it. Got to let them eat it. Okay, go. Where you go, Woody? Where you go, Nuggy?
Nah, I'm going for a big, big harp hooker this time. We're going big. I'm going to catch one as big as Woody. That's the plan. That's what we're doing. We're just going to hit that bottom first. Yeah,
swimming to under a leech. Nuggy's in. Yeah, he's doing it manually as well. He's got an electric reel, but he's winding manually.
Okay,
that's
now
fine.
What do I do?
No, you can wind it all the way up manually if you like.
How do we do it?
Okay, well, you just pop it on the rod holder.
If you really don't
want to do too much work and do that. And then you can, you want to grab yourself a sea legs? Yep. Well, fish will just bring itself in. Unless another shark. Another shark, something might have this. Shark might have this. Somebody's grabbed this, I think. Get ready. We just had a shark or something grab a hold of this, whatever we had on then.
Oh, wow.
Wind it up, bro, wind it up. Shark gets it. It's a pooka nonetheless though. We got a pooka, first drop. We're getting through the species, boys. Lift your rod tip up. Lift your rod tip up. Give it a wind as you're lifting.
Oh yeah.
You got them on, do you think?
Give it this one.
You one
there, mate, we're the technology, we might as well use it.
Yeah.
You getting bites there too, bro?
One. I told you, Nug.
There you go, better have a sea legs, mate. Better grab yourself a sea legs while you're winding that in. There you go, you're doing a good job there, Gus. Keep it up, mate. Yep.
Yes!
Yeah, you go, my son.
All right.
Yes!
Woo-hoo! Yeah, boy!
Yeah, mate, we got the technology, mate. We might as well use it up.
I
wanted to. I want to make sure I wasn't losing him. I didn't trust it. Oh, give me a sea legs. Gee, we've been waiting for that.
Yeah, oh, that's a good. You got a good fish on. You're doing well there, mate. You're doing well. Keep it up.
Oh, shot my luck.
Okay, wine, manual wine. Blue dogs, boys. Here we go, another species, boys. And you won't get a much better eating fish than this one.
There you go, blue dog.
Blue dog.
Blue nose. Racking them up, that's another few points here. That'd have to be close to 60 points, that one.
Plus the 5 points for the sea legs.
I don't know if this
one. Floating. Good fish. Stop there.
Oh, big blue nose.
Oh, bloody.
Oh, he's boy.
That was a good fight there too, Sam. That was well worked there, Kano.
Jeez, I'm knackered.
But that's a nice, like, we don't normally get on this inside little mark here, we don't normally get real big ones, but that's a good fatty boy.
Yeah. That time I started contributing.
What are those holes?
What are these? Nostrils, yeah. Yeah, nostrils. So they've got a sense of smell as well, which they need sensors down there because it's so dark. But their eyes, see a lot of the other fish, like the squid and little fish that are down there, small eyes, they can't see much. So these things have got a predatory advantage where they can just come up and grab them.
What a horrible place to live down there.
Yeah, well, little Hamilton.
Oh, that's awesome, man. That's awesome.
It is, mate. Well done, bro.
Yeah.
You're a big slab.
It's all right, mate. Like, just on the boat, keeping a close eye, is the strength and conditioning coach. Well, I'm the opposite to that.
Yeah, he's all for this.
I'm the unconditioning coach. Recreation and unconditioning coach. Okay, go. There you go, Woody. Yep. Oh, here we go. That's a good fish there, Wood. Give it a wind. You're all right, nice and smooth.
Giving a good old tug. Ooh.
Hold on, Wood.
You're gonna drag me over.
It's a nice blue nose.
Oh yes.
That's a nice blue nose, boy. That's a nice one for here.
Oh yes.
Yes, Woodster. That's a good blue nose for these parts, mate.
Yeah. Oh, it's massive.
Oh, bro.
Well done, mate. Look at the size of his gob.
Yep, this time we went for the squid and a little secret weapon here. This rig's been doing well. I've got a little flashing light on this rig. And, there you go, blue nose, mate. We're cracking through the species.
Good.
Woodster. Get a few pics of him, mate. I'll get you to take one, Sam, and I'll jump in there because this fella's making this fish look too small. I need to be in there to give it some.
He's slippery.
Get over there, you slippery huh? All of that slime there is like a mucus layer because it's like down deep. Down there, there's all sorts of parasites and creepy crawlies that live on the bottom that would get on them and suck their blood. So they've got that slime so nothing can grip onto them. And, yep. So what you guys, that's what you need to rub on yourself, Sam, when you go out.
Creepy crawlies.
Just keep all those creepy crawlies off you.
You're talking from experience.
All right, guys, call out to both boats, north and south. That is full time. So lines up, reels in, and back to the boat ramp.
As we make our way back in, Team North are brimming with confidence after their strong second half performance. But we won't know who's taken out this year's North versus South challenge until the points have been tallied. But now with the fishing done, the teams catch up to share in their fishing yarns from the day and enjoy some of the catch fresh off the hook.
Love a good fishing, mate.
Then it's back to the aftermatch and prize giving. And once the referee has checked the photos and the catch sheets, it's time to announce the winners.
We're going to start with most improved. By no means was he a standout, but he improved from last year. Crocky, please come forward and accept an underwater ocean LED light.
Yeah,
one of these, you'll better strap that to your boat and that'll help you raise the fish.
Thanks very much, brother.
Well done, Crocky. Thank you for not wrecking anything this year. Like every rugby game has, there's player of the day. And when we look through the catch sheets, there is one name that just stands out. It's just in there more than any others. It's Nuggy.
Yeah.
There you go, mate. Well done, mate.
Thank you.
Be careful with that. And there's no loading it. There's no loading that tonight. So now we come down to champion team. Both respectable scores. We've got a team on 868 points, which is almost 10 metres of fish. It's pretty good. And the other team on 1196 points, who's going to be taking away the whole kit, is North. So that's us. That concludes it for another year. I know this isn't going to be over, but it's over for the show. So see you next week. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this episode. But if you want to see the most up-to-date action, including this swordfish that I'm hooked up to now that's about to jump, you can get more action for free, as well as all the tips that go with it, at ultimatefishing.tv or download the Ultimate Fishing app. Here we go. Oh, there he goes out there.